This question is about the topic locus from the book B4 O-level Mathematics. In this question, two straight lines AB and CD intersect at right angle at the point O. Therefore, AB and CD are perpendicular to each other and they meet at point O. This is line AB, and let us mark one point here. And now we will draw line CD on this point, and that line CD will make angle 90 degree with line AB. So with the help of this D, I mark a point at 90 degree. And then I will join this point and this point to draw a line CD, and that will be perpendicular to line AB. And this red line is line CD, and this point is O, where both lines intersect each other, and this is 90 degree angle. And in this question it is mentioned, draw each of the following using separate diagram, but we will draw all these four loci on same diagram. So the first one is to draw the locus of a point, and that point is 2.5 centimeter from a one fixed point. So the locus which is equidistant from a one fixed point, that is the locus which has 2.5 centimeter distance from a one fixed point, and that locus is called circle. So to draw a circle, we will use compass, and we will open the compass 2.5 centimeter. And then we put the compass needle at point O. O is the center, and then we draw a circle. The radius of the circle is 2.5 centimeter. This pink circle is a locus. And if you are on this locus, your distance from this fixed point O will remain constant, and that distance will be 2.5 centimeter. So therefore, a locus which is equidistant from one fixed point is circle. So you have to draw a circle whenever it is mentioned in the question that the locus is has a fixed distance from one point. So that locus is circle. In the second part, the locus of a point that is 3 centimeter from CD. CD is a line. So it is a locus which has fixed distance from one fixed line. So a locus which has fixed distance from one line, that is parallel. And the locus has fixed distance from this line CD. So a locus which has fixed distance from a line, and that locus will be a parallel line with this line CD. So we have to open compass 3 centimeter wide. So this compass is open 3 centimeter. So first we draw a 3 centimeter arc on the corners of the line. It should be a semicircle, and bring the compass, this compass here, and draw one more arc here. And draw arc on the other side of the line as well. Now join the top of these arcs, and that will give you the parallel lines. In the same way, join the top of the curves, and this will give you the parallel line on the other side of the line C. Now this whole black locus is a path which has distance 3 cm from the line CD. So wherever you are on this locus, your distance, your perpendicular distance from the line will be 3 cm. It will be 3 cm from here, 3 cm from here, 3 cm from here. So everywhere your distance will be 3 cm. So this black locus, it's a locus which is equidistant from of line CD. So a locus which has equidistance from one line, that is parallel line, and a curve on the vertices of that line. The third part is the locus of a point equidistant from C and O. So it is a locus that is equidistant from two points, and those two points are C and O. As we discussed in one of the previous video, a locus which is equidistant from two point is perpendicular bisector. So we have to draw a perpendicular bisector of line C and O. So to draw a perpendicular bisector of one line, that is CO right now, you have to open this compass you should open this compass about more than half of this line, half of line OC. Arc in this side and the same arc on the other side, and draw second arc on the other side of the line, and then bring this compass over here. Now draw line here, and then now we will join these two intersecting, this point of intersection and this point of intersection with the help of ruler. Now we will join these two points with the help of ruler. Sorry. So this blue line is a locus which is equidistant from point C and O. What does this mean? It means that wherever you are on this line, your distance from point O and point C will remain constant. It will remain same. And this is perpendicular bisector of point C and O. And remember, the locus which is equidistant from two point, it is perpendicular bisector. Perpendicular bisector means it will cut this line CO at the midpoint, and there will be 90 degree angle here as well. The last point, the locus of a point equidistant from line OB and OD. So if you concentrate on this part, the line OB and OD, where in both the lines O, the letter O is common. What does it mean? It means that these two lines will cut, they will intersect at O. So it means that line OB and OD, basically they are intersecting lines. So a locus which is equidistant from two intersecting lines, and that locus is angle bisector. So here this is line OD and this is line OB. And this angle is 90 degree angle, and this is the angle between these two intersecting lines. So a locus which is equidistant from these two intersecting lines, OD and OB, that locus is basically angle bisector. Therefore, we will draw angle bisector of these two lines. So we will draw the angle first here, and there is no restriction how much this compass should be open, wide open. So it is up to you. So now I will draw angle over here. So once you have drawn angle at the point O, so it is up to you. Now you can open this compass more, and then bring the needle of the compass over here, let me open it more. It is up to you how much you would you like to open it. So okay, then I will, then while the needle is over here, just draw one arc. And without disturbing the compass, bring the needle over on this side of the angle and draw a second arc. You can see here both arcs intersect over here. No, I will join this intersecting point and this point O, and that will give me the angle bisector. Now I will join this point, sorry. Therefore, this is the angle bisector of line OD and OB. The first one was a circle, which is equidistant from fixed point O, and the second was the parallel lines, which are equidistant from a line CD, and the third one was line bisector, that is equidistant from 2 point, and the fourth one was this angle bisector, which is equidistant from two intersecting lines.